she'll love me, even when I'm not very lovable. I keep telling myself it doesn't matter because love can't save this. I keep biting back tears after seeing things that remind me of the plans we'll probably never fulfill. Do you remember when I love didn't hurt? When sweet nothings were simply that, nothings. When they weren't spit out like consolation prizes used to fill the silence that keeps falling between us. Are you tired of the silence too? Are you up right now, hurting for what we lost, for what's become so hard? That ring getting heavy. Used to be my fresh air, but now it seems like I'm drowning. I'm good at being hurt, but better at being angry. I'm working on that. It's funny how quickly we fall, how soon the water rises, how we both swim to safety, but forget that we are each other's home. What does that mean? If in crisis, we still do not reach for each other. It takes a special kind of woman to walk away, to restart, to build herself from the ground up again. If we're being honest, I'm not hurt. And my heart keeps breaking, but I'm still hoping you'll catch the pieces, that after everything, you still think me yours. If we're being honest, I hate that about myself. Thought myself new-age woman, take no shit woman, woman who loves herself, and she does not need yours too. But instead, I am here. One foot in, one foot out, halfway looking for what I know I have in you, but too stubborn to forgive. I wake up with regret. After a night spent pretending this doesn't hurt, that these men deserve me, that I even know what I deserve these days. I am sitting in a 7-Eleven parking lot at 11 p.m. texting a man that isn't you, explaining to him that I can't give him something you already have, that I have nothing left to give to men, that I am tapped out. He wants exclusivity, safety, to know that I won't leave or entertain other men. Ironic though, because I guess he wanted the same thing. I have always been a hurricane, beautiful from afar, but dangerous up close. I keep asking them to stay back, but they love the way the waves crash against the banks. Take solace in knowing that after destruction, the sun will still rise. They think I'm the sun, completely unaware that I'm actually the storm. Cognitive dissonance. Is it still called heartbreak if you're the one who broke it? Do you still get to hold this pain if you're the one that walked away? Will it mean I am a quitter? That everyone was right? Will it mean I am a terrible person? I've never allowed myself to cry for this, for us. When you burn something to the ground, are you allowed to mourn the ashes? I'm looking for exits again, crafting my escape route, and I wonder, do you find someone who makes you more of you? Change for them, or do you simply quiet the voices in the back of your head? Is that what love is? I'm deleting your pictures off social media because that's what people do in breakups. And you already blocked me from yours, so I guess I should follow suit. But an absence of pictures doesn't correlate to an absence in my heart, in my memories, and I'm scared if I delete them all, I'll be with us. Maybe I already did that when I left. How do you erase something you so willingly allowed to be a part of your identity? How do you start over without the person you wanted to end with? How do you rebuild yourself? I spent a couple months floating, going from bed to bed, searching for everything you promised me. And I leave unsatisfied because they weren't you, didn't smell like you, didn't feel like you. And some days I fake it well. Laugh real loud, smile real hard, but on days like this, when 1,000 people have told me happy birthday, I'm simply waiting for you. I know I shouldn't feel this way because I walked away, but I left my heart with you. So I'm like divorced now, and apparently when you're divorced, you can't say you're single. You're like, I gotta say I'm fucking divorced. Stupid. So I wrote a poem about it. They will give you a name, a label, something to better help them understand such tragedy, because you were supposed to fold, to break, to do anything but be standing here. So they dismiss you with this name, hand it to you, seemingly like a consolation prize for besting a game you never asked to participate in. You will hold this label. For some, it will be heavy. For others, it will feel like a badge of honor, evidence that you didn't just make it all up, proof that someone sees them, that someone believes them. But never forget, you were something before this, that they don't get to name you, they be something after this, that this isn't the climax of your story, not even the best chapter. It is your choice whether you hold on to this name, but living isn't the same as surviving. Living is so much more. You deserve that much. I see you trying your hardest to give what you don't have, voting yourself over and over again to make room for him, to swallow him whole, because maybe, just maybe, you'll be cool that way. This yearning inside you will stop if you complete each other. But how can you teach someone to love the parts of you you have not met yet? The parts of you refuse to acknowledge and everything in between. So I kind of realized like a lot, especially like with young love, like I got married at 20, and I've been with him since I was 17, and I realized a lot of it was me trying to like hide from myself. Like I wrote something the other day, like, did we love each other because it felt good? Did we love each other because we look good? Or did we love each other because it's easier to ignore yourself if someone's standing next to you? And like, I think a lot of that is a lot. I think that's a lot of what we do when we first like start figuring out what love is, you know, like we find somebody that helps us look good and ignore ourselves and shit. Did we love each other because it felt good? Did we love each other because it looked good? Or did we love each other because it's easier to ignore yourself when there's someone standing next to you? But yeah.